cool is the wind that our mother nature blows through the glade beyond the forest where her sunlight seldom shows. Following her guidance, stray eyes spy a broken soul, sitting shackled by his sorrow, desperate yearning to grow old. His mind of questions dying, for not a single answer found. Hope falls prey to emptiness, in tender tears he drowns. A vile, indescribable despair was in his eyes, commanding death to take him to where his family flies. Visions like buckshot blind him, his life relived within his head. Through tragic pen and paper, I expose the life he's led. His mother was a truck stop whore, pleasure sold by dark of night, living day by day, pathetic, out of her head come daytime light. Her body was her income, every John just a ride, to drive her deeper in addiction to the perfect powder high. Then, on a nameless day in August, on a $20 bed, just turning tricks as usual to keep the hunger fed, as her pay for pleasure partner played with his grubby property, in careless blind obsession, he gave deep to her his seed. When told she was with child, she fought for a life anew, wanting to weave a better world as the child in her grew. Several nights spent in the mirror crying, stark reality becoming clear. She was not a natural mother. Instead of love, she wrestled fear. Depression deep and dominant as the months kept rolling by, and several times starting and stopping, deep, dark thoughts of suicide. But a bright light grew inside her as month 9 came close to call. She would give her all to be a mum, and she was determined not to fall. Finally, the day it came, young life inside her wanted free, as she lay within that hospital bed, starting to freshly bleed. The child placed upon her chest as she fought for every breath, as she stared into his innocent eyes, without any remorse or regret. In one last breath, his mother died. She gave her life for his. With tender tears of lonely love, she left him with a kiss. He felt his infant life was stolen, a brutal crime. He was alive. For if his infant heart had halted, his mum would have survived. taken in an orphan without home or family name. Thrust alone into a world hosting tragedy and pain. Just one out of many, a forgotten afterthought. Love completely absent, loneliness all he was taught. Fed only when convenient, never offered warmth or care. Taught the world was an empty place, so much sad sorrow to bear. Showing nothing on the outside, inside each year cuts deep new scars. Watching the world pass him by through his playpen prison bars. Wanting only hugs and holdings, receiving only empty stares. A helpless, tiny mind slipping silent to despair. Each year his body grows, and each year his heart and soul, they die. Trapped prisoner of a twisted, unfair, tragic, broken life. Several years behind us now, he is a young man of 16. Now in the foster system, hoping for his own life and family. Sadly, the situation none the better. Fostered in a broken home, beaten daily, mind and body, forced to fight his fight alone. Sitting quiet in his room one day, just watching his TV, in staggers his foster father, holding Jack Daniels, drunken clean.
You, a big badass now,
his false dad yells.
Boy, you ain't no fucking man. Get off your ass.
He kicked the chair.
Come on, boy. Take a stand. I said, on your feet, boy.
He screamed again, twisting his fist tight in the boy's hair, lifting him and throwing him through the stale, smoky air.
Show me you're a man now, boy.
He taunted with Satan in his eyes. His knuckles blanched and whitened, clutching the bottle at his side. The boy stumbled to his feet, intent to escape him and the room.
Where are you going? Get back here, son. Your daddy's far from through with you.
His false father's hand, a racing blur, the bottle glinting in the light with the crushing sound of glass to bone. His body halted the fight. Woke up bloody from forced slumber in his dark room, all alone. Through his tears, he decided it was time to leave this happy home. So he packed what little he carried and what little cash he saved and slipped out the bedroom window, looking, hoping for a better way. Time passed again, as time will do, since the boy had run away, living jobless, cold, and hungry, and on the streets, a human stray. He ate from backlot dumpsters, begged for a change from passers-by, his entire life kept in a shopping cart. He slept in the park at night, finding food on some days, and other days he would not eat. Fighting illness through the elements on the cold Chicago streets. His mind, a swamp of sorrow, and his will, all but decay. Each morning, wrestling in his mind to take on another day. Then, one brilliant morning when the sunlight kissed his skin, his eyes opened up to beauty. A young woman sat with him. He shied right back away from her, his head held down in shame. She gently took his hand in hers. You don't have to be afraid. I promise I will not hurt you. I wish only to set you free. Help you turned your life around. Oh, please, sir, trust in me. She said to him, "It is okay," her voice soft as silken strands. "Come with me," she told him, and offered him her hand. She gave him food and clothes, a wash, and most precious, she gave hope. She tore away the tangles, untied the noose of his life's rope. As time marched on, emotions swell and love from pity grows, and the broken boy, now healed man, on bended knee, proposed. "7 years of nothing, lonely. His life, for once, was fair. Together with his angel and a house to call his own. For the first time in his broken life, the man felt like he was home. Late one morning she approached him, a soothing glow about her frame, and said, 'You better get to thinking, Dad. Your new child needs a name.' His eyes pools of wet happiness, his heart pumped crimson glee. First a wife sent down from heaven, and now a child by his seed. Unsure how to accept the happiness, the emotion fresh to him, with open arms he welcomed it. He let that joy flood freely in. Through the months they shared the wonder, eagerly awaited brand new life. Every day his love kept deepening for his truly angelic wife. 9 months of preparation, building cribs and painting walls, were unable to prepare him for the night he got the call." The nurse's voice was hard and cold on the telephone that day. No feeling nor compassion as she spewed what she had to say. "Your wife is having trouble, sir," the cold voice of the stranger said. "The cord, it choked the child, sir. I'm sorry. Your boy's dead." Like lightning leaving heaven to her bedside, that man flew, his every thought that of his angel and the son he never knew. He knelt at her bed and trembled, holding her hand tight in his, and prayed to God to save her. "Please, don't let it end like this. Lord, I've always sought you, never strayed away from grace, despite a life of hardship. I have always known my place. But Lord, I've withered trails far more ever than my share. I do not have strength left within me. Please show me you are there." In an instant, the silence shattered. Alarms rang out loud and quick, pushed back by hospital staff, her blood gushing fast and thick. Life roaches in a spotlight. Clueless doctors ran about, pushing drugs and packing gauze, but her life was draining out. She shook helpless, uncontrollable, and looked empty into her husband's eyes. A single tear to say, "I'm sorry." Then, just as his mum, she dies. Knowing he's alone again, life back where it began. Robbed violently of family, and once again, a broken man. A rage within him festered, he let loose a mighty roar. Staggered to his feet, weakly he walked out the hospital door. So now he sits beneath a tree on the outskirts of the glade, scared to live another day of death. He's unafraid. His teary eyes look to the sky to ask one last time, "God, why? Why did you find it necessary to haunt me all my life?" He reached into his pocket and pulled out a jagged blade, held it to the heavens. "I'll be there with you both today." A quick slice of flesh upon his wrist without regret or pause. He welcomes in the weariness his crimson loss will cause. He stands to take his final breath, arms spread open to the sky. As he lived, a broken man, a broken man, he dies.